As you probably know, nootropics are mainly natural compounds that can improve your cognitive performance, including your memory. Now, some nootropics can improve your short-term memory, others can improve your long-term memory. But the question is, which are the best nootropics for improving memory on the market right now? Let's find out. Hey, what's up? Greg here, the founder of Your Inception. Welcome to my channel where you can learn top secrets about nootropics. Subscribe below to start your journey. No matter how old you are, having a great memory can help you in all aspects of your life. There is no doubt about it. Now, until recently, we used to believe that improving memory was basically impossible. Same was true for improving your IQ, but today we know that we were wrong and you can actually improve your memory. And the great thing about it is that you can improve your memory quite quickly and you can do it in many different ways. Now, my favorite one is by taking nootropics or nootropic supplements. Yes, there are really supplements on the market that can actually improve your memory. They're effective, they work, there are studies behind them proving the benefit. And today in this video, I'm gonna share with you the best nootropics for improving your memory. And at the end of the video, I'm gonna share with you where you can find the best nootropic supplement that can improve your memory. By the way, guys, have you ever thought about improving your memory? How could this benefit your life? Let me know in the comment section below. So the first nootropic that I really like and that can actually improve your memory is called alpha-GPC. So alpha-GPC is a very popular cholinergic compound that is marketed as a memory booster. Now, it can improve other parts of your cognitive performance as well. It can improve your cognition, slow down cognitive decline, but mainly it is used for improving memory. Now, I came across studies that were done on mice and they showed that supplementing alpha-GPC can improve your verbal and working memory, and this can help you be extremely productive. Now, as I mentioned before, there are other benefits of taking alpha-GPC, such as it slows down your cognitive decline, for example, or it can even increase your power output. And because of all those benefits, alpha-GPC is often added to popular nootropic supplements. Now, the recommended daily dosage is somewhere between 300 to 1,200 milligrams per day. But in most nootropic stacks, you're gonna find around 200 to 300 milligrams of alpha-GPC. And that's a great dosage if you intend to use this nootropic supplement for a longer period, which I would personally recommend. Another amazing nootropic for improving memory is Bacopa Monnieri. Bacopa Monnieri has been used for centuries in Ayurveda medicine. And it's a great nootropic. It's an adaptogen herb that can improve your memory, it can improve your cognitive performance, it can slow down cognitive decline, it helps people that are under severe stress, and it possesses antidepressant effects. So as you can see, Bacopa Monnieri is used for several different things, and there are studies that I found that prove most of the benefits that I just mentioned, which is the main reason why Bacopa Monnieri is so often added to the best nootropic supplements available on the market. Now, the standard daily dosage is around 300 milligrams, but keep in mind it has to contain at least 55% of the active compound, because that's the compound that provides most of the benefits that we just mentioned. Oh, and one more important thing, you need to take Bacopa Monnieri for at least 8 to 12 weeks to really get all the benefits. So this is a long-term nootropic that I recommend taking for a longer period, and you shouldn't really expect some amazing short-term benefits, especially regarded to memory improvement. Another nootropic that I wanna mention is called centrophenoxin. Now, this is not a typical nootropic, but it is somewhere between a nootropic and a smart drug. It is severely under-researched. This is the most under-researched nootropic that is on my list, but I still wanted to add it there because there are a couple of studies that I found that really show a lot of benefits or potential benefits and a lot of potential in general for this nootropic. Now, the preliminary studies show that it can boost cognition in elderly, but of course, as I mentioned, we lack studies on healthy individuals, so we'll have to wait for that. Usually, it's difficult to find centrophenoxin in nootropic supplements, but you can buy it as an individual compound. So if you want to experiment a bit, this is a great nootropic to try it out. But until we have more research, I would not recommend taking it in a longer term or longer period. The daily recommended dosage has not been established yet. Some people recommend taking up to 750 milligrams per day, taken in three daily dosages, so 250 milligrams times three times. So this is something to start with, but yeah, do consult your doctor and do more research before supplementing it. By the way guys, I've revealed 7 special secrets about nootropics that no one else will tell you about. To get them, download my free handbook below. Another amazing nootropic for improving memory is called citicoline. This is, in my opinion, the best nootropic supplement you can currently find on the market for improving memory. It provides a whole range of benefits. It can boost your overall cognition, and of course, as I mentioned, it can also improve your memory. Now, there have been quite many studies done on animals that show the positive benefits, but also on healthy individuals. And that's the thing that I'm always searching for. So studies on healthy individuals. And what I found is that citicoline really seems to be beneficial. Now, we have it in our brains already. This is a natural compound, but by supplementing it, we can increase the levels of citicoline in our brains. And this seems to be beneficial for improving our memory. Now, based on the studies that I've done, this is a nootropic that should be in every serious nootropic supplement. Usually you're gonna find it as Cognizant. This is a brand that is selling citicoline, and they developed a synthetic version of it. Apparently it's a very, very effective one. It's legal in the States, it's legal in Europe and in other countries around the world. So it's a really great nootropic. Now, the recommended daily dosage is somewhere around 200 to 300 milligrams per day. You can take even more, but for the long-term use, I personally would recommend taking around 250 to 300 milligrams per day. Another interesting nootropic for improving memory is called ginkgo biloba. Now, I'm sure you heard about ginkgo biloba before, because it is, I believe, the most widely used nootropic on the market. It's very popular for many reasons, but if you look at the studies, this is one of the less effective nootropics on our list. Now, we used to believe that ginkgo biloba is a great nootropic for improving cognition and memory, but more studies that have been done show that it is really not as effective as we thought, especially it doesn't really provide the benefits for healthy individuals. If you are a bit older in the cognitive decline, yes, ginkgo biloba can slow down cognitive decline, can potentially even improve your memory, but if you're younger, healthier individual, then it's a question of how ginkgo biloba effective really is. Personally, I would not take it as an individual compound, but if I would get it as a part of a more complex nootropic stack, then I wouldn't mind taking it at all. Now, the recommended daily dosage is somewhere between 120 milligrams to 2 grams per day, which is a huge difference. As far as I know, in the United States, you can take a much higher dosage as a supplement, whereas in Europe, for example, higher dosages are already marked as medicine, so you should really not take it, or you are actually not allowed to buy a supplement that contains more than, I don't know, 200 or 300 milligrams of ginkgo biloba per day. So that's kind of how it is. It's a bit different how Americans look at ginkgo biloba than Europeans. It's really on you to decide, but as I said, it's effective, but not as effective as other nootropics on this list. By the way, guys, if you have any questions, do let me know in the comment section below. Use a hashtag AskYourInception, and I will weekly answer some of the most interesting questions that I will receive. Another nootropic that I want to mention is called Huperzine A. Now, this used to be a very popular nootropic, and you could find it in some of my favorite nootropic supplements. However, recent studies and some more know-how that is available now shows that long-term use of Huperzine A can be potentially dangerous because it works on acetylcholine, which is the learning transmitter, and that's how it actually provides the benefits for improving memory and learning and so on. However, long-term use seems to make you more addicted, and as far as I understood, it's really not recommended to take Huperzine A more than a couple of weeks. You need to cycle it then. So until more is known, I would not recommend taking Huperzine A as an individual compound. Also, personally, I would avoid supplements that contain it. Yes, we know it works. It should be on the list because it is effective. The standard recommended daily dosage is around 200 micrograms per day. But yeah, keep in mind that we really don't know how it's gonna act on you or what kind of side effects can you expect in the longer term. So until we know more about it, I would try to avoid it just to be on the safe side. Last but not least, let's talk about curcumin. Now, I'm sorry for the pronunciation. That's a really tough one for me. You'll see the names below if you're not sure which nootropic I'm talking about. Now, this is slightly unexpected to see it on such a list, because you can actually find curcumin in kitchen, basically. A lot of families have it at home, not as a supplement, but as an active compound in turmeric. And another funny thing about curcumin is that it is, by definition, it's very effective because it contains a lot of antioxidants and it's also anti-inflammatory. However, some studies show that it can also improve your memory. I'm not sure if this can happen directly because of certain active compounds that it possesses, and I think researchers, based on my research, also not sure about it, or your memory improves as a side effect, a good one, obviously, because of other benefits that curcumin brings. The issue with curcumin is that it's poorly absorbed, so you need to take it with piperine, and the recommended daily dosage is around 500 milligrams of curcumin taken with about 20 milligrams of piperine, and that's how you should expect certain benefits of curcumin. All right, guys, so we just covered the most popular and the most effective nootropics for improving your memory. Now the question is, which is the most effective nootropic supplement on the market that I recommend? Now, as you know, I've been testing nootropic stacks for quite some time, and I'm constantly upgrading my list of the best nootropic supplements based on the research, based on my experience, based on the results that we get from taking and testing nootropic supplements. So to see which is my favorite nootropic supplement, check below their links, which will lead you to one of the sites with best nootropic supplements, which is constantly updated, and it is based on the evidence, on my research, on my experience, and that's where you're gonna find the best nootropic supplements for improving your memory. Now, personally, I would like to see most of the ingredients that we just talked about in the nootropic stack. There are a few exceptions. Curcumin is one. It is not as effective as it seems to be. The second one is ginkgo biloba, and the third one is centrophenoxin. So much about best nootropics and nootropic supplements for improving your memory. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any question, don't hesitate to contact me. Don't forget to follow Your Inception on Facebook and Instagram. Don't forget subscribing, and I hope to see you soon again.